Start first by turning on the iPad if it isn't already in standby mode. The button's right up here on the top. Takes a few moments to load. Once the iPad is started up, you turn on the piano, pushing your remote power switch. The Bluetooth will beep twice at you to let you know it's going. Then you select the music button. Looks like a couple music notes. And these are your albums for all the songs that are on the play on the piano disc. You can also select the button up at the top that says music and select that there, and you can actually list the individual songs. It gives you all the names of the songs that you have. So you can go by the names, or I like to go by albums. It's easier to search when you have so many. So push on an album. You can select a song that you want to hear. If you want to change the volume, you just change the volume here. Filled with songs, the whole. To make a playlist, you're gonna push this little music button here. And down here at the bottom of your playlists, you make a new playlist. So you can give it a name here. We'll call it Christmas. And then you push on add music right there. And you go to your library of music, right? You come down here and let's see here. You push on that one there. So now we got all the songs from that album you can select. So you have like Silent Night and Oh Holy Night and The First Noel. Then you say done. Okay, those songs are in there. Then you add more. So you go to the library and down here. Christmas songs, sing-alongs here. We'll go with Blue Christmas and Frosty the Snowman. We're done. So now you have that whole playlist in there. The name of it is Christmas. Say done. So, I mean, you can be listening to music, but then when you want to suddenly play a playlist, you just come down here. There it is, Christmas playlist. Click on that. Hit your play button, and it's going to play all these right down there in your Christmas. Thank you. When you're done playing music, make sure you turn off the power to your player piano. And then you can either just push this temporarily, put it in standby, which will, if you're using it within a few days or so, I always leave it on standby so it powers up quicker. It doesn't use up much power on standby mode. And then when you turn it back on, it comes back up right away. But if you're going to be going away for a long time, you're not going to be, you know, operating it, you push and you hold the button on the iPad, and that brings up this slide to power off. Just slide this to power it off, and then you're off. But make sure that when you turn it back on again, that you turn on the iPad first to get it started before you turn on the piano. It's an important fact.